Hello everyone, this is Big Money Chasing Big Money by simply being smart about buying phones. This video again is going to be a bit extraordinary. There will be no analysis or charting or anything like that. I will just cover what I already know about the upcoming Solana phone, which is set to be released somewhere in the first half of 2025. The reason why I'm doing this now is because there is a pre-sale going on at an unbelievable discount, which will be closed soon, and I want to draw your attention to this opportunity in case you don't want to miss it. I will go through all the things that I expect from the next chapter of Solana phones, all the airdrops that I anticipate, and eventually the possible return on the investment, comparing it with all the airdrops and bonuses I have already received from my first Solana phone. I will also make some speculation about what hardware we can expect from the new device next year, so let's just jump right in. It has been almost a year since I got my Solana Saga phone, and I can tell that it has been one of the best investments I have made in a long time. Let's have a quick overview of all the airdrops and bonuses I have received since, simply by owning the device. I actually managed to mint two Klaino NFTs with the phone, which have a floor price of 20 SOL each. Now, in today's prices, that is around $4,000. Of course, at the time, Solana was nowhere near the prices that we have today, but still, have I had held on to these lovely little creatures, I would have basically 4K in my wallet. The next one is Bonk. There was a massive airdrop for all the Saga phone users in the amount of 40 million Bonk tokens, and at that time it was worth around $900. Today it would be $600. And then I had a Saga Monkeys NFT, which was actually airdropped to my wallet, and I sold it for 10 Solanas, which is just over $1,000. Then I also got a Samoyed token, which is roughly around the $20 mark, probably above that today. Then I got some print protocol tokens. So yeah, actually the list goes on with different projects jumping on the bandwagon to support the Solana phone, which originally looked like was going to be a massive failure financially and in the terms of product launch as well. However, with the rise in the price of SOL, the chain getting much deserved recognition, bundled with the guaranteed airdrops, within a few days the entire remaining stock got sold out. So what can we expect from the upcoming device? There are already some impressive backers behind the project. There is Magic Eden, Tensor, Jupiter, Phantom, Solflare, Drip, Helium, and the list goes on. Based on the first project, here's what I assume would happen. Owners of the new device would receive special NFTs and perks from the NFT platforms like Magic Eden and Tensor. Token airdrops would be coming from Jupiter, Phantom, and Solflare. Special subscription plan from Helium, although this would only be applicable for users in the US. On top of all this, I believe there would be other up-and-coming projects that would jump at the opportunity to harvest some of the hype around the new device and have sort of a mutual promotion. At this point, it is difficult to anticipate the value of all this. A lot depends on where Solana will be in a year's time. What is safe to say is no matter what the value will be of the airdrops and bonuses, these promotions go hand in hand. Phone owners will be interested in the projects that they get airdrops from, and those investors who are interested in the projects will want to have the phone just to get the freebies. So it's in everyone's best interest to have significant amounts deployed. Now let's talk about the hardware. The first question we should ask, is the Solana 2 going to be a mobile phone at all? Well, it is not for sure. It might be as well a super smart wallet. I could imagine something like the Stax wallet by Ledger, except with a much more advanced display. Or even an AI handheld device like the Rabbit, which runs entirely on artificial intelligence. Nonetheless, I think it is safe to say that the most probable scenario is another mobile phone. Considering that this will be the case, what is the phone going to be like? The Solana Saga was designed by the Awesome team. They were a truly professional group who were previously working on the Essential Phone project. Mobile device enthusiasts will know this name very well. In case it is unfamiliar to you, the short story is that they have been designing amazing phones that kind of go against the mainstream Android trends, and they delivered powerful hardware configs with top-of-the-line quality builds. The Saga was also such a well-designed phone. I mean, I still consider it to be far more superior than any phone I have ever touched. The ceramic body, the dimension, the screen, everything just says premium. In terms of hardware, it was the high-end range when it was announced. Unfortunately, though, they had manufacturing delays, and by the time the phone started shipping, it became slightly outdated with the Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1, while other phones were already out with the Gen 2. What does it all say about the next model? Well, it is difficult to anticipate what the hardware specs of a phone would be that is due to be released in a year's time, but unless there are issues again with global chip manufacturing and shipping, I'm pretty sure it will be whatever the peak combination of components are of the time. The latest CPU by Qualcomm, the fastest RAM with plenty of capacity, and the storage would also be around 1 TB. The only thing I don't expect anything special from would be the camera. All that being said, and considering that everything starts to revolve around artificial intelligence lately, I would not be surprised if this time the phone would focus on combining crypto with AI. Now let's talk about the price. Most importantly, how much would this device cost? At this early founder's purchase window, the price is $450. If the same hardware approach would be applied to this model as it was for the first, it is an amazing bargain, no question about that. However, you will need to lock in this money for at least a year until you actually get the unit in your hands. Put on top all of this, all the airdrops that are expected to be provided for the users, and the whole deal becomes a no-brainer. Alright guys, this was a short video about the upcoming Solana device. I hope I managed to shed some light on what is expected to happen. If you feel like jumping in, I have included an order link in the description field. Take care guys, see you at my next video.